because everything that I hear from my father, I have made known to you. You did not choose me, but I choose you and appointed you so that you should go and bear fruit, and that your fruit should remain. And so, whatever you will ask of the Father in my name, he will give it to you.
God, have mercy on us. present here today, that they may be delivered from affliction, wrath, danger, spiritual, physical need, and that they may live in peace, good health, and well-being of the days of their life. O merciful Lord, yes, and have mercy.
Благаємо тебе за безмежне милосердя.
Патріархія Православного Святого Великого Князя Володимира, охрестителя нашого українського народу, святу православну віру, покровителя святого храму цього, нехай помилує і спасе нас, бо він є милосердний чоловік любець.
Ukrainian Orthodox Church of the USA, pastor of this cathedral, Father John, and all our parish family members, I thank you all for coming for this afternoon, small event service, prayer service, for the peace of our homeland, Ukraine. Our hearts and thoughts are overwhelmed by the destruction we hear about and see it taking place all over Ukraine and the suffering of her people. This Russian Federation war was brought upon by only one man, who is determined to invade and destroy our nation of Ukraine. Дорогі Христі, мої брати і сестри, від імені Предстоятеля цього Свято-Володимирського собору Української Православної Церкви Сполучених Штатів Америки, владики Даниїла, настоятеля собору отця Івана та всіх наших парафіян, я щиро вдячний всім вам, що ви прийшли сьогодні після обіду на це богослужіння молебен, де ми, як одна Христова родина, молилися за мир в Україні. Бо всі ми переживаємо про ті страшні події, про які ми чуємо, ми бачимо, що відбувається по всій Україні. Всі ми переживаємо за наш народ, який страждає в цій війні. Цю війну Російської Федерації розв'язала лише одна особа, яка налаштована вторгнутися і знищити народ України. However, Ukrainians are strong, proud, and willing to defend their country. We Ukrainians here in the United States of America are thousands of miles away, but our hearts, our prayers are with the very brave men and women of Ukraine's armed forces and citizens who are fighting to protect Ukraine from the Russian aggressors. We pray for them and their families, who no doubt are praying that their loved ones will return alive and unharmed. Whether our ancestors came from Ukraine or we are new immigrants, we too are proud Ukrainians, giving our spiritual support, our prayers at this molebin and every single service that here in the United States, the Ukrainian churches having for all who, with no provocation, have been thrust into this war in Ukraine. Many of us have relatives, friends there. It is heartbreaking to see not only soldiers, but innocent citizens dying at Putin's hands just because he wants Ukraine to go back to being what it was as a Soviet Republic. It's not just our native, beautiful Ukrainian land that he wants. He also wants to destroy our Ukrainian churches, real Ukrainian churches, our faith, our beautiful Ukrainian language, traditions, and culture. Проте наша українська нація є сильна, горда, готова захищати і захищає свою країну зараз. Ми, українці, тут, у Сполучених Штатах Америки, перебуваючи за тисячі миль, але наші серця, наші молитви є разом з хоробрими чоловіками та жінками Збройних сил України, всіма громадянами України, які борються за захист України від російських агресорів. Ми молимося за них. Ми молимося за їхніх рідних, які безсумнівно також моляться, щоб їхні близькі, рідні поверталися живими і неушкодженими. Незалежно від того, чи приїхали наші предки з України роками тому, десятиліттями тому, чи ми нові іммігранти, ми є дуже горді українці, які даємо свою духовну підтримку, даємо молитви, як на цьому молебні, та на інше богослужіння, що ми тут відправляємо в наших українських церквах. За всіх, хто без провокації був і є втягнутий у цю війну в Україні. Багатьох з нас, у нас є там рідні, друзі, знайомі, і дуже боляче дивитися, як від рук Путіна гинуть наші солдати. І невинні громадяни лише тому, що він хоче, щоб Україна повернулася назад до того Радянського Союзу. Він хоче не тільки нашої рідної, прекрасної української землі, він хоче знищити наші справжні українські церкви. Чому я говорю справжні? Бо там є та російська церква. Він хоче знищити тільки українські справжні церкви, нашу віру, нашу прекрасну українську мову, традиції, культуру. Today we are also praying for the government of Ukraine, President Volodymyr Zelensky, the cabinet, the government officials who strive and work so hard for peace and tranquility in Ukraine, so that they will succeed in this fight to prevent the Russian invader from ruling Ukraine. We are praying for all the spiritual leaders in the territory of Ukraine who want peace and tranquility in their country to lead their flocks peacefully to salvation. Сьогодні ми також молимося за уряд України, президента Володимира Зеленського, кабінет його, всіх урядовців, які так наполегливо прагнуть і працюють тяжко для миру і спокою в Україні нашій. Молимося, щоб вони перемогли в цій боротьбі і не допустили російського загарбника до влади в Україні. Ми молимося за всіх духовних лідерів в Україні, які бажають миру, спокою в своїй країні, щоб мирно вели свою паству до спасіння. We gather here today, my beloved in Christ, in this holy church, to use a very powerful weapon against the Russian aggressor. Our prayers. This is what the Lord taught us. We must continue to use this weapon of prayer, to pray, to beseech the Lord God to protect Ukraine and her people from the attack by foreigners from the Russian Federation. Сьогодні ми зібралися тут, в цьому святому храмі, дорогі брати і сестри, щоб застосувати дуже потужну зброю проти російського агресора в нашій молитві. Що вчить нас Господь молитися. Ми повинні надалі користуватися цією зброєю молитви, молитися, благати Господа Бога, щоб захистив нашу рідну Україну, щоб захистив весь наш український народ від нападу іноземців з Російської Федерації. And finally, my beloved in Christ, I would like to quote our spiritual leader of the Ukrainian Orthodox Church of the USA, Archbishop Daniel. He says, every time here in the United States of America, at the end of every single speech, there is a beautiful, profound exclamation, may God bless the United States of America. So today, as Ukrainians and all that are here to pray to support our homeland, let us say, may God bless Ukraine and all the people of the nation of Ukraine. І на кінець дорогі у Христі я хотів би процитувати слова нашого владики Даниїла, архієпископа Української православної церкви в Сполучених Штатах Америки, предстоятеля цього собору. Він говорить, кожен раз тут, у Сполучених Штатах Америки, наприкінці кожної промови звучить гарний, глибокий вислів. Нехай Бог благословить Сполучені Штати Америки. Тож сьогодні, як українці та всі, хто є тут, що моляться, підтримуємо нашу батьківщину Україну, скажемо те саме до України. Нехай Господь благословить Україну та весь український народ. Слава Ісусу Христу!
Слава
Україні!
Героям
слава! Слава Україні!
Героям
слава! Слава Україні!
Героям слава!
Thank you very much, everyone, for coming today. And now I would like to introduce to all of you President of the United Ukrainian Organization, Marta Leshenensky-Keller. Прошу, пані Марта.
Brothers of Ukraine. Our Eastern European allies have stood firm, and Poland is also shouldering. Our refugees and war. The American Jewish Committee has been our partner in bringing awareness to the heinous atrocities created by man. Unfortunately, this moment in time will add to our work. Please welcome Regional Director of AJC Cleveland, Lee C. Shapiro.
And strength to those who live in fear. Incline the hearts of national leaders towards peace and reconciliation, and bless them with the wisdom, vision, and perseverance needed to end this war and restore peace to the region. Almighty God, strengthen the hands of those who pursue peace, not war. Bring harmony where there is hostility, relief where there is pain, and hope where there is despair. May the one who makes peace in high places make peace for all on earth. May this be your will, and let us all say, Amen.
Stand with Ukraine. So when you go home and drive north or south, Village. You'll see all those signs in our businesses. Very emotional for the council people going out, and it was just a small act of be there, do something, say something, and that's what we're trying to do here as the city government, to let you know we are here for you, for your Ukraine. And I'll close with Savia Ukrainian. Thank you. God bless Ukraine. God bless you.
Concerned about Congress. You see how that's going. I think we can put together a majority to maintain our support of Ukraine. I can guarantee you no nation on earth has done more for Ukraine than the people of the United States of America.
America needs to take peace to act.
I wish we could do it tonight. I wish we could. And think of what kind of retaliation could come. President Zelensky.
Think about the Ukrainians who are dying and fighting for democracy.
President said he does not need a right, he needs ammunition and not fire.
Sir, there are people risking their lives right now from adjoining countries to Ukraine to move arsenal into Ukraine. I can guarantee you, and I'm not going to say which countries, people are risking everything to help Ukraine. But what we don't want nuclear war. And we don't want those who are risking their lives right now to have their brethren wiped out, because we are dealing with someone who doesn't think like you do, and who has enormous power. And all of the nations, all of the free nations of the world are working together in a way that I have not seen since I was extremely young. And so what we have to do is keep our alliance together. And I appreciate the ambassadors, representatives who are here tonight from Lithuania. I don't know if there's a Polish representative here this evening or not. I'm of Polish heritage. Believe me, the Poles are risking. Fighting in the Congress, the President just announced $350 million more for armaments and $1 billion of loan guarantees so the nation of Ukraine does not collapse as people go to the banks and try to pull their money out, right? You've seen that. We have to find a way. One of the reasons I came tonight, and I could give a long speech, and there are others on the program, you're partnered with Lviv. I've been calling several ambassadors. Ohio is partnered with Hungary and Serbia in our National Guard. What can we do that is extraordinary? You come to the House of Representatives, there are words above the speaker's rostrum. One set of words says, "In God we trust." And the other set of words at the end says, "To see whether we in our day and generation may not do something worthy of remembrance." This is our moment to do something worthy of remembrance, right? We have a special responsibility in this part of America because we have you. Do you think your kind of group would exist in a place like northern Wisconsin? Not exactly, although there are Ukrainian Americans and Polish Americans in Wisconsin. But we have something really special here. I'm looking at the Podinsky family who've given their lives to founding and building up with all of you, the Ukrainian Museum and Archives in Cleveland. It's the best of America. It's better than Harvard University. And I'm saying to you, if we don't empower organizations like that to send content to the news networks, we're not doing that yet well in our region. We're not doing it well. You have stories. We're not telling them. The world needs to hear the stories, individual stories like Story Court for people of Ukrainian American heritage. You owe it to your parents, your grandparents, all of those who are fighting now. We need to inform the world to hold together the political coalition that is necessary to win. And I'm in the game to win. Get yourself in a positive mode. Think how we use our power to win. First, win the war of messaging. Do you know, think about this. Remember the weeks before the invasion? Okay? Our American intelligence services were on the ground all over that region, in places that you and I will never get. They were able to tell the world what he was going to do, the maniac from Moscow. Who did that? You'll never know their names. They're Americans. I'm sure we lost some of them, and we'll never know who they are. But they informed the world what was going to happen. There is no less responsibility on you to help tell the story. And we have to go, we have to, Senator Portman and I, two of your elected people, we have to go to the president and ask that the voices of places like Parma are heard and used in these national broadcasts, because you know how your family suffered. That is not coming through. They're seeing the suffering now, but a lot of the younger people in our country, the majority, have no idea what you have endured and your families have endured. We have to tell them. That's part of winning. Part of winning is making sure you're not silent. Turn your tears into a communication stream. Ohio, I mentioned, Hungary, Serbia, we have airplanes. The governor of Ohio has just declared today a day of prayer, right, for Ukraine. So why can't we fill those planes? Our pilots know how to fly. They know how to get to Hungary. They know how to get to Serbia. I was on the phone today with someone who's a refugee from Hungary. Here's what she said to me. Marcy, I have the route. If you can get the cargo in to Budapest or to an airport in Serbia or Hungary, I know the route to get it into Transcarpathia to help all the women and children who have no flour, they have no blankets, and they're lining up at the borders right now. I said, where's our guard? Where's our guard in Ohio? We can do this in Ohio. We must do this. We must do our part. I called the Polish ambassador this week, and I'll end very quickly here. I said, Mr. Ambassador, the first ship that usually calls at the port of Toledo is from Poland. I have a question. If there are refugees, can we bring some of them back here where they will be welcome? And then when the ship goes back, let's send goods. He goes, oh, I said, yeah. After World War II, a great President Eisenhower built the St. Lawrence Seaway for just this moment, because it is the shortest distance from America to the ports of Northern Europe, and we aren't doing our job right now. Those ships ought to be full, once the ice melts, and move goods in, but right now we can fly cargo, and we're not doing it. So what I'm saying to you is, working with your elected officials here, we need your best suggestions, because we will make them happen. But you have to help us, because you know what's on the ground. I bet you if you took every person in this room and you got a map of Ukraine, you could figure out what we have to do in order to be successful, okay? And I was on CNN yesterday, for those who are concerned about fighters, President Zelensky may have heard my voice, I don't know, but we're looking at volunteer brigades from around the world, soldiers who will fight, and units that will become part of the Ukrainian army to try to bolster them at those places where they need help. Now, I heard today that President Zelensky had agreed, and I don't know if he's still, if that's still in the news or not, because I've been on the road, that he wants to have discussions with President Putin somewhere near the Belarus-Ukraine border. I am very nervous about that. Because if you look what happened in Poland in 2010, when the entire Polish leadership was killed flying over Starobielsk near Katyn, and if you go back to the Hungarian Revolution, and you see what happened to those who took the word of Moscow that they would have peace talks, I think we have to advise our president and President Zelensky to be very careful about where they meet, to negotiate what circumstances. I know, I'm glad Senator Portman is here because I know he has a lot of influence. But I don't think we need to accept where they said they will negotiate, because both in Poland and in Hungary, their top leaders were there. And so we have to really be wise about what we do, and you know an enormous amount. As the people in Ukraine are today, and have faith in those fighters, Ukrainians who are fighting for their liberties, who are speaking here tonight. And let's put together something from this part of America that is extraordinary and worthy of martyrdom we watch every day on the television. God bless you. Thank you for being here.
admire our leader. We today on Meet the Press advocated for admission of Ukraine into NATO now.
Freedom from Russia. And now we see the atrocity that is going on as Russia attempts to change history. But the people of Ukraine know, because they've lived under the thumb of Russia before, and before that, the Soviet Union. They know that this is not the way for them. And that's why we are not surprised, are we, that they fight tonight. Because they are fighting for everything that we hold dear, and we know that they hold dear. They fight for freedom, they fight for independence, they fight for Ukraine. It seems to me, as of this evening, the latest report I got from Ukraine, that Vladimir Putin has bit off more than he can chew. Perhaps he miscalculated because he is isolated and not listening to other voices. Perhaps he underestimated the passion and the patriotism and the nationalism of the people of Ukraine. But for whatever reason, the resistance has slowed down for 4 days now what Russia is attempting to accomplish. I will say my worry is that because of desperation, he will begin to deploy even more weapons, more tanks, more air power, more bombs, more missiles. This is why America and our NATO allies and freedom-loving people all over the world must stand up. We must stand up. This cannot stand. I say tonight to Russian commanders in the field, to Russian officials in Moscow, to Russian soldiers, stop this atrocity. You can't refuse to carry out these orders that are meant to kill innocent civilians, your neighbors in Ukraine. Stop this atrocity.
Some of my colleagues, let's be honest, have questioned, why are we doing this? Why
Why should we care about Ukraine? Some have indicated that Ukraine is not important to them. What they care about is America. Well, if you care about America, you care about Ukraine. This is where the fight to protect freedom is being waged. This is where the cause of freedom in our generation, in our time, is asking for our help. Again, Ukraine has chosen to stand with us. We must stand with Ukraine. Slava Ukraina! Slava Ukraina! God bless you and God bless the country of Ukraine. They must continue to absorb the blows until Putin, by pressure from without and within, has been removed from power. If he is allowed to just halt operations and return to his version of the Russian border. In the name of cessation of hostilities, then Crimea and the Donbas are lost forever. And the liar and the bully is rewarded and emboldened, and the world loses interest in its resolve. And while the animal will have returned to his cage, the cage remains. There will be no rest for Ukraine, and Ukraine will not flourish. Sunflowers will not grow in Putin's shadow. Today is the beginning, and with the end not yet in sight, I call on the diaspora and our friends to hold fast. To victory, Slava Ukraini!
Thank you.
нашому українському народу і президенту України, всьому уряду, Збройним силам України, grant, O Lord, to the servants of God, all the Ukrainian people, Ukrainian government, President Vladimir, his cabinet, the armed forces of Ukraine, the government of the United States of America, peace, health, salvation, and keep them for many blessed years, Бережи, Господи, на многое благое лето.